Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Another recommended name was Trae Bell Haynes. He had a great season for the Karlsruhe Marlins in German BBL and was amongst the best players in the league. He averaged 18 points and 7 assists per game in this season, and in the 4 playoff matches against Bayern, he averaged 28 points and 5.3 assists per game. Trae is playing a lot with the ball in his hands and his usage is usually high. He can score points in many ways and he's improving as a shooter from distance, but I think there is still room to improve in this area. The release isn't the quickest and smoothest, especially when taking shots off the dribble. With his handles and quickness, he can create some separation, so his shots aren't blocked that many times. In spot-up situations, he looks more confident and usually sinks those open shots. I think he has the potential to be a consistent 35% plus 3-point shooter, especially if we take in consideration that he is very efficient from the free throw line. With his quickness and great handles, he doesn't have much problems getting to the rim. Has great touch at the rim, but sometimes struggles and finishes under contact. He lacks size and strength in the upper body, but on the other hand, he knows how to draw a lot of fouls and go to the free throw line where he's pretty efficient. His size could be a smaller issue on the top level, and sometimes he can get into some hard spots that lead to turnovers. A big part of Trae's game consists of pick and roll actions. He has great feel in those situations and usually makes the right read when to shoot, pass or attack the rim. He knows how to use the screen to get some advantage and separation. Also very good at finding the popper and pick and pop situations, and this was a big strength from Karlsruhe in this season. Playmaking is another big strength from Trae. His court vision is on a high level and can deliver passes in all directions. His off the dribble passes and pick and roll actions look really beautiful, but some of his passes can be way off or too soft, and he needs to make a little better decision because his turnover numbers are just too high at the moment. Trae is also dangerous in transition. With his quickness and tiny body, he can push fast and go all the way to the rim. Controls the ball well and really fluid on open court and very efficient in fast break situations. Again, sometimes making unnecessary turnovers, and there is room to improve in this area. Let's move on his defensive game. His perimeter defense is pretty good. He can slide his feet well, has solid reactions and reads the offense well. In my opinion, he should sometimes be a little more aggressive and put more pressure on the ball handler, and with his quickness go for more steals. His pick and roll defense on the other hand has more weaknesses. Trae has some size and strength limitations and is not capable of initiating much contact and controlling the ball handler. With his tiny body, he should be able to maneuver around screens better than he's doing at the moment and not get stuck on screens so easily. I'm not really expecting Trae to be an elite pick and roll defender, but I think he's capable of more than he has shown so far. There is room to improve in his off-ball defense too. His court awareness and positioning is sometimes completely off, losing sight of his man or helping when it's not his job to help. He falls out of the defensive scheme too often and needs to put more awareness into that. To sum up, Trae Bell Haynes is an interesting player that is improving his game every year. He was recently called into the Canadian national team and will probably represent them in the upcoming qualifications for the Olympic Games. He is usually excelling when his usage rate is high, so it will be interesting to see him with a smaller role in the team. His offensive game is on a high level, the size limitations are causing some problems and finishes at the rim, but his size is also a big plus in drawing some fouls and getting to the free throw line. He needs to make some better decisions and take better care on the ball because his turnover numbers are too high. There is a lot more to improve on the defensive side, especially in his awareness. In my opinion, he will get some attention from some teams in international competitions, but I think he is not ready for the highest level yet, but with a few improvements he could get there in a few years. And this is it for this time. If you like the video, smash the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. If you miss any previous reports, there's a playlist on the screen now and you can check them out. See you in the next video.